type of leaf is simple. So this green expanded part, so there is no dissected or not divided. So because of this, we can say simple leaf. And arrangement is, as you can, you are observing this picture. So this is opposite. Sometimes minutely sub-opposite also. Opposite or sub-opposite arrangement of the leaves will be present. So in this picture, you can clearly observe. So here there will be presence of axillary bud is there here. So that's why you can consider it as simple leaf. Okay, type of leaf is simple. Arrangement of leaf is opposite. Or sometimes you may get like sub-opposite also. And also you can observe the leaves are sessile. The stalk of the lamina will be absent. Means the petiole is absent. Directly the lamina, which is directly attached to the branches. Okay. And also you can observe some of the flowers. This picture. So in this picture you can clearly observe. So this is the branches. The branches of Woodfordia floribunda or fruticosa. So this is the green expanded part. So it is directly attached to the branches. So the petiole is completely absent. So you can say the leaves are sessile. Leaves are sessile. And also you can observe the margins of the lamina is entire. Margins of the lamina is entire. So this is the width. And this is the length. Length will be more. That is 2 to 3 times more of lanceolate. Okay. So this is another picture you can observe. So from the axillary region, so the inflorescence they used to develop. Okay. So this is the entire margin. Length will be more compared to the width. And sometimes if you can see, so the margins of the lamina is even the parallel. So based on this character also you can say oblong. So this is the pictures of the leaf. So you can take about the swarupa. Habit, it is a deciduous shrub. Means deciduous means the leaves will fall in particular season, especially during the summer season. As the flowering season, it starts from March onwards, flowering will start. So during the flowering season, the leaves will fall. All the leaves will fall, only the flowers will be present. So when you observe from long distance, so definitely it looks like there will be a fire because the color of the flowers. Okay, so that is deciduous. Means leaves will fall in particular season. That is especially during the summer season. So all the leaves will fall. Once again, during the rainy season, so the new flowers will come. Okay. So it is a deciduous shrub which grows about approximately around about 10 feet height. Okay. And branches are long. Have shown. So branches are long because the length will be more. That's why they used to look in downward directions. It is pendulous and spreading. Branches are spreading. Bark will be smooth and peeling off in fibers. I have shown to you, like in case of Arjuna, there will be exfoliating flakes will be present. In the same way, here also the outer, the stem bark, it is easily peelable, the peeling of the fibers part. Next, we'll move to that leaves. The type of leaf is simple. Type of leaf is simple. Arrangement of leaf is opposite. I have shown in the picture. Arrangement of leaf is opposite or sub-opposite. Sometimes it may be some variation is there. Almost all opposite is there, but sometimes you may get like sub-opposite also. Shape, ovate, lanceolate, or even oblong. Ovate, lanceolate, even the oblong will be the shape. And apex is acute. The margins of the lamina is entire. And size approximately around about 5 to 10 centimeter in length. And 1 to 3 centimeter width. And the leaves are sessile because the petiole is absent. Leaves are sessile, petiole is absent. Okay. Type of leaf is simple, arrangement is opposite, shape is ovate lanceolate or oblong, apex is acute, the margin is entire, and the size of the leaf is 5 to 10 centimeter, length 1 to 3 centimeter width. Next, we'll move to the inflorescence. So in this picture, you can observe clearly the inflorescence is axillary. That is from the axillary region. The whole branches. Usually, so during flowering season, so almost all leaves will fall. Okay, I will show another pictures. There almost the plant is not having any the leaf. It is during it will starts here. Once the flowering start, almost all the leaves will fall. So this is, you can observe how the flowers are clustered. There is bunch of in bunches. This is another picture. So here you can observe about the flowers. So in this picture, almost all the leaves are fallen. So from that reason, the flowers, they used to develop. So here this is the flower bud. So it is not yet opened. Here this is the opened flowers, you can observe. So here the calyx and the corolla is almost all having the same equal length. So androecium part, so this is okay, a tubular like structures. So this is another picture of, it is a small, the corolla is going to dissect and forms the some like the dentate margins. So this is another picture of the flower. That is, in some text they have given like adapushpi, means the flowers which looks in downward directions. In downward directions, adapushpi is also one of the synonym of dhataki, based on its there is downward spreading nature. So this is the flower bud. This is the fruit. After complete, once the fertilization takes place, so after that, so this is the persistent calyx will be there. So when you open this, so inside that you can observe, it was somewhat, it looks like an yavakara. The fruit is somewhat, it looks like yavakara. Okay, so this is the fruit of dhataki. So this here you can observe, so there is no leaf in the almost the branches. The totally whole plant is absence of the leaf. Only flowers will be present. So if you observe from the long distance, it looks like fire. That's why fire of the forest is dhataki. Fire flame bush is dhataki. Palasha is fire of the forest. Dhataki is fire flame bush. Okay, inflorescence, 2 to 15 flowered, same inflorescence. 2 to 15 flowered. They are in bunches. In bunches, 2 to 15 flowered, same inflorescence. And flowers, the size approximately 1 to 1.2 centimeter long. 1.2 centimeter long. Color is bright red and fresh. When fresh, it is bright red, but it fades after on drying. As you all know, the petals are slightly longer than the sepals. Petals are slightly longer, as in case of dadima, in the same way. So that's why nowadays dadima, they have included under Lythraceae family. Almost all the characters are, they are similar or they are near. Okay, that's why it is same. As in case of dadima, there will be a persistent calyx. The calyx will be thick. And it is almost as same the corolla. Okay, so petals are slightly longer than the sepals, and the petals are tubular. The same like in case of dadima, fruit is capsule. Whereas in case of dadima, that is berry. Here it is, type of fruit is capsule, size 1 centimeter long. About utpatisthana, so as subiksha is one of the synonym that denotes. The plant is commonly available. Okay, so it is common in hilly areas of the tropical and subtropical parts of India. It is common in hilly areas of tropicals and subtropical parts of India. In hilly areas, you can abundantly the plant will get. Even in some of the gardens, as the flowers are very attractive, so they used to cultivate. They used to grow in the gardens because of its attractive flowers. Okay, next we'll move to the chemical composition, its phytoconstituents. Flowers containing becogenin. So becocides, please, can you recollect the becocide A, becocide B, some of the alkaloids which is present in Becopa moneri, Brahmi. Here becogenin, lason, actacazenol, woodfordins A, B, C, gallic acid, ellagic acid, tannins, camphorol. So these are some of the important active principles. I will show you some of the pictures or chemical, the structures. Sorry, there is no, not downloaded. Okay, next we'll move to the rasapanchaka. So regarding the Rasapanchaka, there is a difference of opinion among the acharyas, among the Nigantukaras. So some of the Nigantukaras, they used to say like Kashaya Rasa, Lagurukha Guna, Shita Vire, Katavipaka. As you all know, the properties of Arjuna. In the same way, this is also used to mention Kashaya Rasa. Kashaya Rasa, Lagurukha Guna, Shita Vire, Katavipaka. That is Samana Pratyara of the Dravya. But some acharyas says, even there will be Katurasa is also there. That is Anurasa. Okay. Kashaya, Katurasa, Nagurukha Guna, Katavipaka, Shita Virya, Pitta and Kafashamaka property. Pitta and Kafashamaka property. If you write Kashaya Rasa, Nagurukha Guna, Shita Virya, Katavipaka, that is also correct. Okay. So Kashaya Rasa, Nagurukha Guna, Shita Virya, Katavipaka, Pitta and Kafashamaka karma. Next, karma and rogagnata. So the important karma, if you remember the properties of Kashaya Rasa karma, so you can easily write. Okay, so that is the important karma of Kashaya Rasa is Stambhana karma, Stambhaka. So it is indicated in case of Atisara and also like in case of the Pradhara conditions, like Rakta Pradhara, Shweta Pradhara conditions, it is Kashaya Satmaka Dravya. So it is indicated in case of Pradhara conditions. Atisara Hara karma, so indicated in case of Atisara. Mutra Virajaniya karma, one which gives the normal color to the Mutra, that is Mutra Vikara, Garbasthapaka, that is in case of Garbhashegata Vikaras, like there will be a habitual miscarriages. In such type of conditions, you can use this drug, Garbasthapaka Karma. So we'll see according to the Bhava Mishra, he used to give how it is going to act like a Garbasthapaka, how you have to do the Amayika Prayoga, he used to mention. Okay, so Garbasthapaka, that is indicated in case of Garbhashegata Vikara or in case of the habitual miscarriages. So it can be used. In case of Visarpa, that is, it is indicated because it is having Visarpa Harakarma. And Madhakara, that is mother to the Krimis. Mother to the Krimis. Madhakara and Vishagna, Visha, Trishna Hara, indicating case of Trishna. And Runa Shodhaka, so indicating case of Runa. So in case of Bhala Atisara conditions, Atisara person, that is Atisara, which has happened to the pediatric conditions. Balatisara, Dhataki Pushpa, Sharkara, Laja. Dhataki Pushpa, Sharkara, Laja are mixed and administered to the child, will check the Atisara, will stop the Atisara. So you can take the Dhataki Pushpa Churna. Dhataki Pushpa Churna, for that you can mix the Sharkara plus Laja, that is Parchripeddi. So that both the Churna, Dhataki Pushpa Churna, Laja Churna you can take. For that you can add the Sharkara. The powder, you can mix it properly and it is administered. You can mix along with the honey or along with you can give the Ushna Jal also you can give in case of Atisara conditions. In case of Pravahika, that is Dhataki Pushpa Swarasa, Badara Patra Swarasa, Kapitta, Lodra Churna, Madhu and Takra. So if you take all these together, so we'll stop or we'll check the Pravahika. Okay, so Dhataki Pushpa Swarasa, Badara Patra Swarasa, Kapitta, that is Belvalakai. So that you can make in the form of powder, Kapitta Churna, Lodra Churna. So all you can mix it with the Swarasa and you can take along with the Madhu and Takra. So we'll stop the Pravahika. So in case of Kushta, Dhataki Lodra Vatsaka Bija, here Vatsaka is a synonym of Polarina antidecentrica, that is Vatsaka Desha, the plant one which is available in Vatsaka Desha. Okay, that is Kutaja, Vatsaka Bija, Karanja Bija, Malati. From this you can prepare the Kalka. So that Kalka is applied over the affected areas. In case of Kushta, so you can collect the Dhataki Pushpa Churna, Lodra Churna, you can prepare the Vatsaka Bija Churna and Karanja Bija Churna plus Malati. So with these drugs, you can prepare the kalka. So with the help of this kalka, you can use the gomutra depending upon the condition. You can take the drava dravya and you can prepare the kalka. So that kalka is applied over the affected area. In case of pitta abhishandhya, that is in case of netra vikaras, dhataki churna, chandhana churna and sthanya, that is the breast milk. You can take the dhataki churna plus chandhana churna. For this churna, you can add sthanya, that is breast milk. You prepare the lepa, that is used as an anjana in case of pittaja abhishandya, like chakshugata vikaras. In case of kathara, that is in case of dhatakyadi avaleha, we can prepare the dhatakyadi avaleha, that is indicated in case of pradhara. And in case of runa, dhatake kusuma kvata, dhatake pushpa kvata, that is used for runa prakshalanartha. Runa prakshalanartha, you can prepare the dhatake kusuma kvata. And it is lukewarm, that is you can use for runa prakshalanartha, which helps in wound healing. Okay, by removing the kalpa which is present in the runas. In case of shweta pradhara, dhatake pushpa churna plus madhu is given. Dhatake pushpa churna plus madhu is given in case of shweta pradhara. This is prajastapana, like garbhastapaka. In gada nigraha, we'll get nilotpala. Utpala is the type of kamala. Nilotpala plus dhatake. Nilotpala plus dhatake are mixed and taken with the madhu in the morning during Rutukala. During Rutukala, you can ask that lady to take Nilotpala plus Dhataki along with the Madhu, which helps, which does the Prajastapana Karma. So this is, we'll get in Gada Nigraha. Okay. So next we'll move to the useful part. The official part is Pushpa. Okay, apart from Pushpa, nowadays there are so many research activities which are carried out on Dhataki Patra also. So Dhataki Patra is also having the Runaropana Karma and also anti-ulcer activity which was done on Dhataki Patra, anti-ulcer activity and Runaropana Karma is also going to be takes place by using the Patra. But mainly we are using Pushpa, Dhataki Pushpa. Matra, Churna 1 to 3 gram and Vishishta Yoga, Pushyanuga Churna, Brahat Gangadhara Churna, Aravindhasava, Dhatakyadi Churna, Dhatakyadi Avaleha, and like Ashokarishta, Arjunarishta, Kanakarishta, Kanakasava. So almost all of the Asava Arishta Kalpanas, so definitely it contains Dhataki. Okay. So by this I want to conclude the today's topic, that is Dhataki. Okay. We'll see in the next class with another new drug.